Scott Benton, this was potentially, you would say, a controversial position for an MP to take, but as I just mentioned, that YouGov poll would suggest that the public are very much on your side.
I think that's definitely the case, Dan. This is a classic issue where the general public have a completely different opinion on this than the out-of-touch liberal metropolitan elites, and I'm including members of parliament within that. The vast majority of my constituents were absolutely appalled by this evil and barbaric act, and as far as they are concerned, there's only one appropriate punishment, which would be the death penalty. That is, as a society, that's the only way we can signal our absolute revulsion at this barbaric act, and in my opinion, that's the only appropriate crime.
And Scott, what has been the reaction since you made the call to reintroduce the death penalty for child killers?
I've received hundreds of emails, Dan, from people up and down the country who are just so thankful that somebody has actually gone on television, as I did several days ago, and spoken their mind, because this is one issue where politicians and members of parliament like myself aren't supposed to express a controversial opinion on this issue. We're just supposed to conform with a decades-old idea that a mandatory life sentence for killers is enough. Well, frankly, it isn't. The British people demand better, and that's why I was so pleased to go on TV and reflect the views of my constituents on this issue.
No, and I congratulate you for that, Scott. Can I just tell you my main concern, though? If you study criminal justice, there are cases in every country, in liberal democracies, in the third world, where innocent people are sent to their death because of miscarriages of justice. That's my concern. And I think it's an overwhelming concern. That means I will never be able to support the death penalty. How do you deal with that problem?
Well, Dan, since we abolished the death penalty in this country 60 years ago, criminal justice techniques have moved on a huge amount, as has the justice system. So we're not talking about the death penalty for every single murder here. What we are talking about is exceptional crimes which have particularly repulsed the nation. For example, the awful killing of Little Arthur would be one. Potentially so would the killers of Lee Rigby, being the same category as deserving of the death penalty. And in both of those instances, we have DNA evidence, we have CCTV footage, we have TV footage in the case of the killing of Lee Rigby. So the perpetrators are beyond doubt in these cases. So the concerns people would have about a miscarriage of justice would not be appropriate. And that's why I'm only calling for the ultimate punishment in a small number of particular murders where there is irrefutable evidence of the perpetrators.
OK, Scott, thank you so much for putting your case. Stand by, because I want to go to Diana Constantinidi. And Diana, I really wanted to speak to you about this because obviously you are a human rights lawyer and that's why we have you. But you have a particularly personal connection to the to this type of situation, because I believe your mother was tragically murdered. You don't support the death penalty, though, even despite such a difficult personal experience.
I guess there's two ways of looking at this. The first one is under my professional capacity as a lawyer, which I do not agree at all, indeed, with capital punishment. But of course, through that and being able to study through the years of becoming a barrister and with my personal experience, I never, ever have I desired the death of the murderers of my mother. I believe in transparency. I believe in accountability. I believe in justice. I believe the worst thing you can do for a human being is to deprive them from their freedom. And that's the way we should be approaching those matters of a civil and democratic society. And I do agree with one point in relation to old school methods or decades of anachronistic views. And I will agree with that, because capital punishment is one of those things. The last time United Kingdom saw a capital punishment was on the 13th of August, 1964, one in Liverpool and one in Manchester. And actually, I was going on through reading the process that these people were executed. And why would we do eye for eye? Why would we want to respond to a heinous crime with another heinous crime? That's not the answer. That's not the way forward. That's not a way of respecting human rights. And I stand by it. But may I just add one last point?
Yes, of course.
Because you mentioned about the criminal justice system, and I want to take a step back. I would like for all of us to take a step back. And that's a reflection about our criminal justice system. It is a complex system because it has to regulate the alleged, actual, and criminal activities within those procedural limits. So as you very correctly pointed out, there are some people that they've been innocently prosecuted and they may have been found guilty for a number of different reasons. And we have to make sure that there is a fair process in place, including sentencing, to ensure and safeguard that. And yeah. According to the sentencing guidelines, there is that. And that's the whole life order. And perhaps the judge who sentenced the two defendants who should have considered that.
Dominique Samuels, how do you respond to that?
Speak out against the death penalty, I think they view it in ways that I wouldn't. So for you to murder or rape a child, I think that's the greatest evil that you could ever inflict on somebody else. And there is no eye for an eye where that is concerned, because you using the death penalty against someone who's murdered a child, I don't believe those acts are equal. I personally view that as justice. You know, Colin Pitchfork, for example, child murderer, he was released, soon went back into prison for, as far as I understand it, plotting to kill people again. Baby P's murderers, the murderers of James Bulger and now of Arthur Hughes. Prison for them, I don't think, is justice, because even if we talk about James Bulger, for example, his killers, so much money was spent on giving them new identities, yeah. giving them a new life.
Despicable.
When they tortured and murdered yeah. a two-year-old, and John Venables, one of the people that murdered James Bulger, he went back into prison again 2 years after. For what? Child porn. These people, these types of people, they don't learn. So this whole idea of the justice system being corrective in this regard, I don't think is true.
And where I completely agree is life has to be mean life. These depraved killers of poor Arthur, the fact that they are going to be out makes me feel sick. But Scott Benton, to come back to you, I would say the greater punishment is for them to be locked up, probably being illegally tortured in prison every day, because life for a prisoner is certainly not smooth for someone who has tortured a child like that. And in some ways, do you not understand that the death penalty could actually be the easy way out for these evil folk?
I appreciate that argument. I really do. What I would say, though, just going back to previous comments, the evil and heinous acts, particularly in this case, the murder of an innocent child with his whole life ahead of it. Even a 20-year prison term is simply not appropriate, such as if the evil of these acts, that only the ultimate punishment is appropriate in certain circumstances such as these. Okay. I appreciate your comments, Dan, in terms of taking the easy option. Is it best to let people suffer in prison for a long time? Well, frankly, if we had confidence in the British justice system, life would mean life. Yeah. In these awful circumstances, and potentially that would be one avenue.
But it does, as we saw with Pitchfork.
They know absolutely killers will be out in 10 or 20 years, yeah. and that's simply not acceptable.
Well, look, it's a fascinating debate. Thank you so much for having it. That was the Conservative MP for Blackpool South, Scott Benton, our very own political commentator, Dominique Samuels, and the human rights lawyer, Diana Constantine-Needy. Thank you so much. So who do you agree with? Dave via Twitter says, no, we should not bring back the death penalty. State-sanctioned revenge is uncivilized and fundamentally flawed. Matthew says the system will always be too fallible, corruptible and political to be trusted with such an irreversible punishment. And David via email says, my daughter was murdered and sexually assaulted age 23. Her son was 2 the next day. Why shouldn't life mean life for her killer? Weak politicians have diluted the value of human life and made it easy for people to murder. David, thank you for sharing your story. Your verdict now in. 80% of you, wow, agree with Scott Benton that the death penalty should be reintroduced for child killers, while 20% of you say it shouldn't.